is what I'm going through at the moment. The temptation to have any of these. That one. Reese's. There's a Hershey's one in there. Look at that.
Which one do you get?
I'd probably go for a Reese's.
Right.
Yeah.
Fuck's sake, mate. You're just going to be sat there watching D-Lads eating your box as well. That's so cool. She coming? When's she coming up?
She's the driving at the moment.
It's pretty sweet. I'm happy with that.
Hey, my bummer was ripped off.
You video.
Fucking hell.
Was it a good one,
was it? Was
that
good one?
Fucking sore.
Oh, Freddy.
Wait, wait,
So, final check of my weight before I go to the weigh-in. Gonna see what we're weighing in. I'm wearing a very flattering. What would you even call them? Like banana?
Can you hand out your pants?
Banana, what would you call them? Like banana hammocks or like a, what's that? Tighty white pants. That's what you call them.
No, they're budgie smugglers, aren't they?
Budgie smugglers.
They're not bungee, budgie, budgies. Like a bird.
Budgie smugglers. Right, so last weigh in. They look good, don't they? Can I have a look at the scales then? Lovely. I'll take that. 1 kilo under. Gives me a little bit of wiggle room just in case they're wrong. I had to get them from Aldi, so a bit dodge. But no, I'm happy with that. Water cuts worked, food cut. I stopped drinking last night at about 6 p.m. I only had 1 litre for the last 2 days. So like a litre per day. So that has worked. Thank you, Dion. Next check-in, I'll be at the weigh-in. See you guys then.
It's a lovely day for it, isn't it, really?
You can't see it through the brightness. Right, shall I ask you a question?
Go on then.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how hungry are you right now?
I'd say...
Head south, one being on Stone Circle Road.
One being a fat person that's just eaten, and 10 being a Kenyan that's like about to die.
Right, Christopher, I don't think we should say that because that's not very politically correct.
I'm probably, at the moment, difficult to say. I'd say I'm a solid 8 on that scale.
A solid 8. 8 means not hungry. 1 would be hungry.
No, 1 was being the fat person that's just eaten.
Okay. And if you sniff really carefully, can you smell 12 donuts coming through?
Yes. I smelt that as soon as I got into the car.
Ha 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 ha. Are you excited for your, it's the full way around the roundabout. Are you excited for your competition?
I am.
Do you think you're going to win?
I don't think I'll win. I'm going to do my best, I'm going to have a bit of fun. And yeah, that's all I can say.
This is a trick.
It is very far.
Legit. Like, I'm going to use all my energy up. Where do I even anywhere in here? If I think that's that building over there.
Should I zoom in on it?
Yeah. That is an absolute mission. Why is it so far away? We're powerlifters. We're not 10k runners or walkers.
Now with a 170, excuse me. When you do your first competitions, and as this is my first competition, you don't really want to go for what you predict your one rep max to be, sort of thing. Because if you then don't get it, then you don't put a score on the board. So if you get 3 fails on your squat, No matter what you do in your bench and deadlift, you can't put a score on the board. So you want to go quite conservative. You want to feel like it's moving well. Yeah, and you want to be able to do your first lift especially. So this one wasn't too bad. It looked a little bit slow. That's just because at this stage I was still feeling sick. Like, I weighed in at 8:30. It was more of like 9:15 sort of thing. So from then until now, it was only sort of an hour and a quarter, and that's through warming up and doing like all my eating and stuff. So I was still feeling a little bit sick. This now is my 177.5. When you squat and you do all this, basically the judges, you have to listen to the judges. So they tell you when you can squat, then you do your squat, go back down, come up, and then they tell you when to rack. On this one, I didn't actually wait for her to rack, so that's why they three red lighted me. So yeah, a little bit annoying that I got those three red lights, but it's first competition nerves. So, because I didn't want to just jump to 185 and then fail on 185 and all I'd be left with is a 170, I went for a 180 to stay sort of like a little bit conservative. 177 moved a little bit slow, but I felt quite comfortable under it still. So yeah, this is my 180, and I just had in my head like, wait for the command, because I didn't want to get another three red light for something stupid, just making a silly mistake basically. So yeah, this is 180, she's given the command to go down, squat, and that was actually quite a nice squat. Again, it looked a little bit slow, but I probably had another 2.5, if not 5 kilos in me. I just got a little bit stuck, and it was a pass, so all good. Then, yeah.
There will be pain, there will be scars. Somehow, some freak out there just now. Times are hard behind these masks. Beware, because we get too much tonight. Some freak out. Turn your face away. That look already says it all in your eyes.
So this is my bench 110 opener. As I said again, you don't want to go like massively heavy on your openers. You want them to be quite light, give you a little bit of confidence. So this is my previous 3 rep max. So she's saying down and press. As you can see, move really nicely. So that is why I jumped up straight away. 10 kilo jump, 120, 3 red light, 3 white lights. So here's the 120. This one actually didn't go very well. In my setup, I didn't set up very well. I wasn't feeling comfortable. The spotter came in like really quick sort of thing. I just didn't feel comfortable. I didn't have my feet set. And then as you can see, sort of thing. I almost bounce it off my chest. That's why she says it takes a while to say press. And then if you watch my right leg, my right foot slips a little bit, and then I've sort of got no chance of getting out from there, which is a bit annoying. So yeah, that was three red lights. So again, because I didn't want to jump up and then not get a score, I did the 120 again. This time I took a little bit longer to get set. I just sort of took the spotter out of my mind. I did it all myself, and then waited for a command, and it went up really nicely. Again, could have had probably another 5 kilos in that, but what can you do? Like, I was stupid enough to rush my set up, so there we go. You pull me in the deep, where it's too dark to see. And then these are my deadlifts, so I'll just let you watch these with a little bit of music over, because you're probably bored of my voice by now. So these are starting with 200, and then I went to 210, and then 220. And yeah, as you can see, you can watch all through the clips. Cause I know that we're never gonna make it out here. We're never gonna make it home. Now what I'll do is I'll just let you watch through everyone else's lifts. So I did manage to miss, for some reason, recording Ben and Dion, sorry guys, but I managed to get most of Kieran's, Josh's and D-Waz's lifts in, so I'll let you watch through them. Massive well done, guys, and yeah, awesome lifts. In my darkest hours, was watching as you walk right through me, flow right through me.
welcome back, guys. So, I'm sure you would be boring of hearing my voice by now over the previous videos. I just want to speak a little bit about the weekend. So, today is Monday. We've had such a good weekend at the University National Powerlifting Championships. Well done to the other five lads. You competed so well. You've obviously seen the lifts and they did like incredibly well. Couldn't have been like a better group of lads. So a little bit about my performance. Obviously, you've seen the videos, you've heard me speak about like what happened and stuff. So, a bit frustrating on my squat and my bench. So if I didn't get red-lighted on my squat for not waiting for the rack command, and if I didn't just rush my setup on bench and stuff, then I could have potentially ended up with, like, just on those two lifts, like another 7.5 to 10 kilos like increase. And then deadlifts as well, if I had that 7.5 to 10 kilos increase, then deadlifts would have been like a different game. I might have pushed for like a 222.5. The person that came above me in the total only came 7.5 kilos in front of me. So if I did get that 7.5 to 10 kilos on the squat and the bench, and then I could have like made up that extra like little bit to pass him in the deadlift. So, or I might not have even needed to. I might have got that 10 kilos and I might have stayed ahead of him, but you never know. But anyway, it is what it is. At the end of the day, I finished in third, and with the prospect that I could have finished in second if I'd like had a bit more experience competing, if I didn't rush, if I didn't do stupid mistakes, then I'm so happy with that. But third place, overall, massively happy. There it is. But yeah, just want to say some thank yous now as well. So first of all, thank you to Coach Diwaz. You have been amazing, like all the way through this. You've like believed in me. You've done all my programming, so thank you so much for that. Thank you to the other five boys. So you've got Ben, Kieran, Diwaz, Josh, and Dion. Like, thank you for your support on the Saturday. It meant the world to me. And then Dion's parents for coming on the Saturday and supporting, Josh's parents for coming on the Sunday and supporting. Like, you guys are awesome. I know more parents are watching back home. Thank you to my parents for coming and watching me on the Saturday. It was such a long day, but thank you. And the girlfriends as well. So the two boys' girlfriends, Amelia and Heidi, thank you for coming and supporting. My girlfriend Evie, thank you for waking up at stupid o'clock for my weigh-ins and being there all day Saturday to support. Thank you so much. Our two sponsors, Elitas Fitness. So if you're in the Chichester area, go check Elitas out. They are awesome. My shirt is currently in the wash. You might be able to hear the washing machine as well. So I can't show you their logo or whatever, but I'll put a link below and I might even show you their logo here. And thank you Happen Stalls Solicitors for supplying the rest of the money towards the shirts and taking us out for a big steak after. Thank you so much, that was so well deserved, and the boys enjoyed it so much. So a big, big thank you to you. Yeah, and then I think that's all my thank yous, to be honest. I really am sorry if I've missed you. But no, awesome weekend competing. Couldn't have asked for a better weekend, as I've already said. Came out with third overall. You've seen how all the other boys did. You've seen the lifts and stuff. And yeah, awesome weekend. Just getting ready for the next ones. Next one is a qualifier in 3 weeks' time for then the national championships at Body Power. So yeah, I'm hopefully going to be competing at Body Power. As long as I basically need to hit a total of 4:57, I believe. I totaled 5:20 in this competition, with a little bit more to give. So yeah, a 4:57 total, so I'm just gonna hit for like the 4:60, stay conservative, and then a Body Power, big things to come. I've got my targets in sight for what I wanna hit, and yeah, so stay tuned. Thank you guys for watching, like and subscribe below. Means the world to me when you watch these videos and like them, so it's awesome. I have fun producing them or making them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.
something.